The lessons learned from the extraordinary efforts to eradicate smallpox have never been more relevant as countries struggle to control the COVID-19 pandemic. These lessons can empower us to become better ancestors, to leave the world better than we found it. And if you're like me and have deep passion to uncover the truth and create a better world, you find hope and inspiration in how we overcome these large global adversities, how we can change the world in big, life-saving ways. Throughout 9 episodes of this learning series, we will explore the 9 lessons learned from smallpox eradication, 9 lessons from global health to change the world. We will hear from key experts on how each lesson has been applied or could be applied to prepare for current and future global health threats and to create positive change in our world. In this episode, we will explore lesson 2, know the truth, share the truth, act on the truth. When facing any challenge in our world, uncovering and understanding actual truth is critical. Without reliable information, we may not even know there is a problem. Without knowing the truth, we cannot solve the problem or respond effectively. If we do not share the truth, we cannot honestly know if we are being effective in our efforts. If we do not act on the truth, then we cannot create effective change. It's not easy to learn the truth. It is often difficult to accept the truth, reveal the truth, admit the truth. Sometimes it takes significant effort, resources, and time to uncover the truth. And sometimes political will to reveal the truth. Let's go to the classroom. President Jimmy Carter appointed Dr. Foege as director of the U.S. Center for Disease Control in 1977. He has spent his life finding and fighting diseases around the world. President Barack Obama awarded Dr. Foege the Presidential Medal of Freedom, the nation's highest civilian honor, for his work to eradicate smallpox. Dr. Susmita Parashar is a cardiologist at the Emory Heart and Vascular Center and associate professor of medicine at Emory University School of Medicine. She is a passionate clinician researcher and educator and trains medical students, residents, and cardiology fellows. In addition to being an accomplished medical figure in her own right, Dr. Parashar's career was inspired by her father-in-law and mentor, Dr. Mahendra Datta, who was a field expert working for the Indian government during the height of the smallpox epidemic in India. He ultimately rose to become India's Deputy Director General of Public Health.
In 1973, India was one of the few countries still battling smallpox. They did not know how much smallpox they had. People might have smallpox in the village and never go to the primary health center, so it wouldn't be reported. They might go to the primary health center, and the primary health center may or may not report that to the district. The district may or may not report it to the state. The state may or may not report it to the central government. So they actually didn't know how much smallpox there was. The approach to smallpox at that time was mass vaccination. They had been told by outside experts repeatedly that if they achieved 80% vaccination status, that would stop the transmission of smallpox. We now know that is not true. Smallpox was winning.
Dr. Foege and his colleagues proposed a more deliberate and comprehensive method to identify cases. Government teams started going door to door in villages to gather their own data. Within 1 week of active searching, dedicated searchers found over 10,000 additional cases in Bihar and Uttar Pradesh alone. The new surveillance data showed where the cases were located and revealed that there were many more cases than previously believed. When the central government team confronted the situation, they had two options. One option was to hide or discredit the information. Nobody would be blamed for letting smallpox get out of hand, and consequently, nobody would lose their job. The other option was to embrace the new data, strengthen the new surveillance system, and try a new strategy to control the spread of smallpox. The new surveillance system made it clear that the actual number of cases was more than 10 times greater than anticipated. That fact required rethinking the entire strategy from the ground up. The strategy would require 10 times the number of watchguards, vaccinators, clinicians, and a budget that was also 10 times as much.
Within 4 months, we had really perfected surveillance so that it went from village to village searches to actually doing secondary surveillance in marketplaces, and then tertiary surveillance wherever we expected the smallpox might be hiding. And now we could start working on containment.
Within 12 months, the cases went from a high of 1,500 new cases in a single day, in a single state, down to zero cases in the whole country. Knowing the truth about the virus's precise location and how it was spreading made eradication possible.
You mentioned 1,500 new cases a day in the state of Bihar alone. That meant 1,500 new investigations, finding those people, finding their contacts, putting watchguards on the house, all before we had computers in the field or smartphones. I mean, it's amazing that we were able to do this amount of contact tracing.